down there. There. Oh, yeah. Like a lady. Yeah. Hope I got that on the video.
You get that on video?
I think so. They're short, quick strips, like a.
Oh, did you see that?
Yeah.
Did you get on video?
I think I got on video. I had your head cut off.
We're catching these small tarpon on these 8-weight fly rods with a floating forward weight fly line. Also, you can also use a monocore fly line that is actually a slow sinking fly line, and that works very good too. The flies that we were using were polar hair minnows that are very effective flies. The only trick about these flies is these flies are actually tied in these bait hooks. And if you pull on it too fast, you'll actually have a tendency to lose a lot of fish. The main thing with these type of bait hooks are these semi-circle hooks that more and more flies are being tied with this type of hook, is you want to let the fish do the work. Let the fish grab the fly, and you'll actually feel the fish pull before you pull back on it. But if it's a real hard habit to break, to try to, you know, not when you see that fish hit that fly, to pull back. Just let the fish pull first before you pull it. And remember to use that strip strike. These are some of the flies that we were catching, those small tarpon in the Everglades. The thing about...
Oh, man. Flash. There you go. Oh, almost got on the bone. I love them tarpon. Tripod. I think he's already tired out. Sweet. That was good.
That was cool.
I think I got all that. I hope I got all that. It'd be awesome, man. That shark almost coming out to the bone.
We noticed to get these small tarpon, we actually, on the top part of the high tide is the time that they're most active. They want to have some moving water going back and forth. And here's an example with this chart over here. This is low tide. And as that tide slowly starts coming up, and right around this time is when those tarpon start getting very active. So you want to start fishing the area that you want right from this point on to the slack tide and then coming down. So if you could fish in that spot with the right on this that mountain peak or that tide peak, that is when they're the most active. Also, remember to keep an eye on it. If you're fishing in a lagoon and all that, make sure you see those tarpon rolling, because you could go into this lagoon and wait and actually see these tarpon rolling. Now, if there's no tarpon rolling there, they're not there, so it's not worthwhile. Especially with tarpon, that they actually gulp for air. And the hotter the water is, the more that they'll actually be gulping for air, because they can't get that air from the water. So, keep an eye on the water surface. Make sure you can see those tarpon rolling before you start casting at them. And if you can fish them right there on that peak of that high tide, Man, you're in a good spot, so give that a try.
Yeah, I'm gonna let it sink. Man, you're in the zone. There's one.
There he goes.
A little mini guy.
Not a bad one, huh?
Not a bad one.
Where's it going?
Just hand line him. Found the boat. Let's see that shot.
You getting this?
Yeah, I'm getting this. I got this glare on the.
Thank you.